Hi, it's Ash, and today I'm going to be doing a review on the Louis Vuitton Zippy Wallet.
Okay, so I'm going to begin by talking about the zipper on this wallet. Now, as you can see, there's one big continuous zipper that runs from one side to the top to the other side. And as you can see, it's actually also gold, the zipper, and also the zipper pull is gold, but it's actually made out of brass. Now, when you look at the zipper pull, it's actually pretty chunky, pretty big, and I love that about it. It also has a Louis Vuitton logo printed right here and on the other side, and that's how you can also know that it's authentic. The hole on the zipper pull is actually pretty big too, and it's great if you want to clip stuff like a wristlet. Okay, so I have like a little clip here that I have my leather wristlet attached to it, and I can just attach it to this hole right here, and this is what makes it into a wallet that I can actually carry on my wrist. Nifty, huh? Now, as you can see in my demonstration, for some reason I tend to stop around the corners because this wallet is crafted really well, and the zipper is actually crafted really super tight and really super well, and sometimes it makes it really hard to maneuver around the edges. Okay, so now I'm going to go through all the contents inside my wallet and show you how I store them in each compartment. We're going to begin all the way in the back, and we're going to begin with this pocket right here. And as you can see, you can't see if there's anything in there right now, but I actually have a larger bill in there. And that's the reason why I like this pocket back here. I have a 20 in here right now. It actually conceals it really well because sometimes you don't want to open your wallet and flash how much money you have inside, and so this pocket is really great for that. So it tucks away all your bills really well. Well, US dollar bills, but I don't know about any other types of bills, but it tucks away US dollar bills really well. Right here we have 4 credit card slots, and I've actually doubled up on them. I don't know if you could tell, but I actually have 7 credit cards right now on this side, and I'll explain a little bit later about the reason why I did that. Right here we have the Louis Vuitton Paris Made in Spain imprint. We also have the serial number inside, located inside this pocket. We have compartment number 2 right here where I've put some smaller bills. Sometimes when you just want to put your money in and out really quickly out of your wallet, this is a great place to put it. And I don't like to keep it my small bills in here because this pocket's really tight, and I find that it's really hard to get in and out of this pocket, so I just like to put my smaller bills in here when I need to get money out really quickly. Compartment number 3 is a zipper, and in here I've got some coins. And I don't really actually like to keep coins in here because they're a little bit more dirtier than bills, but for this purpose I've actually have some coins in here. Compartment number 4 has my passport, as you can tell, and this pocket fits a passport really well. You can actually put it in here also. You can also put it on the other side. I don't suggest it putting on the sides because it doesn't fit, as you can see. It does not fit. So the only good areas that you could put it are in these slots. You can't even fit it in this one either. So yeah, it sticks out really bad. So the only good places I would suggest to put is either in the middle or on the insides where I put my dollar bills and receipts. So yep, that's what I keep in compartment number 4. Compartment number 5 is like a little pocket. And in here I like to keep cards that don't fit in my credit card slots, or cards that are like frequent buyer cards. Cards I need to pull in and out really quickly. So right here I got a Sephora card. I'll just put those in there with some business cards. So that's a great pocket. Alright, compartment number 6, I have receipts, and these receipts fit perfectly into this side right here, and as you can see, they don't actually really stick out as much, so I don't have to worry about it ever getting caught in the zipper. Alright, and again, here we have 4 credit card slots. I've only used 2 on the top, and right here we have another pocket, which is compartment number 7, and I haven't used this pocket yet either. So now I'm going to explain to you a couple of things that I don't like about this wallet. Okay, so the first issue that I have with this wallet is the zipper pull that's inside the wallet. When you close it tight, it tends to get this zipper pull stuck either to the left or to the right. It never stays center with the actual zipper that's inside. And what happens is eventually this zipper pull gets squished. And what it does is it rubs on your leather that's inside. And it leaves an indentation, as you can see. Now, you probably caught this when I was showing you the compartments earlier. You see there's one on this side right here? There's also one on this side. Oh, I'm not sure if you could tell. You see that? And that's a real bummer. So the second issue that I have with this wallet is the credit card slots. Now, if you remember, there's 4 credit card slots on each side. And I'm going to begin with this side right here, which actually has the Louis Vuitton made in Spain imprint. And as you can tell, the pockets or the slots are really loose. You see that right there? And that's because I've actually doubled up on them, and that's what's made them a little bit more looser. Now, some of you ladies might sit there and be like, ah! But I actually really like how they look. This side over here also has 4 credit card slots, but it's not as loose as the other side. And this is actually how it looks when you first buy it. It's actually really flush. It doesn't poke out or stick out like the other side, as you can see. Again, here's a look on the other side. You see how they poke out? You see that? So now I'm going to put some credit cards back in here and show you the issue that I have. Put 2 credit cards back in on this side over here, where I've doubled up on the pockets or the slots. And over here I have 1 credit card, okay? And this is where I put all my 1 credit card slots at. So now I'm gonna pull the credit card out and I'm gonna actually see if you could tell what I'm talking about. Did you catch that? I'll do it again. I'm pretty sure some of you caught what I was talking about, but if you didn't, I'll explain it right now. When you pull the credit cards out, it has a tendency to get stuck underneath this corner right here. And right here, this corner is actually the zipper. So every time your credit card goes up and you have to actually pull the credit card out, it might eventually in the future cut into this actual zipper pull or the zipper. And this could be problematic because you don't want a hole in your wallet. So there might be like 2 holes right here, 2 holes right here later on in the future. And that is a problem. Now, I don't know of anyone who's had that problem yet, but I just find that this is really inconvenient to have to pull your credit card out and always have it hit the edge of your zipper. Now, if I put it on the first level, okay, right here, so I'm going to move this credit card out now and put it on the bottom level, it actually also still does that. Can you see that? You can't pull the credit card out all the way without it having to touch it. What you have to do is you actually put your hand in the center of the credit cards, and you actually have to pull your hand into and under the credit card and pull it out, and at the same time push the zipper away to actually get the credit card out without it having to touch the side of the corner. So that is a real bummer if you use your credit cards excessively. All right, so another reason why I doubled up on the slots was because the credit cards are really hard to put back into the wallet. On this side over here, as you can tell, it's actually flush, the slots. And this side over here, it actually, there's like a gap and it actually comes out a little bit more. And so I'm gonna actually demonstrate to you how the credit cards come in and out. See how I can't even like find the slot to put it back in because it's really hard and really tight. So on this side over here, I doubled up the credit cards and I only doubled them up so that later on in the future, I could put 1 credit card slot or 1 credit card into the slot easily. So right now there's 2 credit cards in here and I'm going to take 1 out. And I'm going to put them into each hole just to show you how easy it is now. Much better, isn't it? I also wanted to demonstrate how an iPhone would fit into your wallet. Now, I don't suggest putting it into the sides because when you close it, as you can see, there's actually a huge bump on this side over here. I'll go ahead and close it for you. But it's really tight and it actually sticks up like this. See how it bulges like that? And that's not good. So, yeah, I wouldn't suggest putting it there. If you put it on the other side, it does the same thing. If you put it in the center, That would work. But, it's a really tight fit for this wallet, and that means that you can't have your credit cards, you can't have coins, and you can't have a lot of bills in here. So here's my wallet again, and I actually put all my stuff back in there, and now I'm gonna put the phone into the center. And I'm actually gonna show you that it's super tight. I would not do this to my wallet, I would not close it. And this case that I have on it is actually really tiny, okay? So this is a really tiny phone already. Oh my god, it just kills me having to close this. But you see that? You see how tight it is? I would not store my phone in here all the time and go out and do stuff with it. If I had to, I probably will, but I would not suggest it because it's not good for the wallet. It's not good for the wallet. Okay, so I wanted to show you my Michael Kors wallet and my Louis Vuitton wallet again, just to show you a size comparison between the two. Here they are. Here's the different zipper pulls. You can see the Louis Vuitton one is a lot bigger, and it's actually brass. This one used to be brass too a while back, but the color has faded away, and hopefully the Louis Vuitton one won't do that. But it looks like silver right now. But yeah. The Michael Kors one is actually a little bit more longer, and I think the Louis Vuitton, no, they're both the same height, but lengthwise the Michael Kors one is actually a little bit more longer. Thickness, I think they're about the same, but the major difference between the two wallets is this wallet is really hard, and this one is really soft. See how soft and flimsy it is? I think that's actually what I miss the most and what I wish this wallet was. So the final thing that I wanted to leave you with is how to wear this wallet. You could tuck it underneath your armpit and carry it like this, or you can carry it in your hand like this. And the other way to do this is attach a wristlet and actually wear it around your arms like this. Well, that's it for my review, and I hope you enjoyed it. Please leave a comment below with any questions, comments, or any suggestions on what you would like to see in the future. Goodbye!